बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। डियर स्टूडेंट अस्सलाम वालेकुम। इट्स मी डॉक्टर मंसूर खान, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ केमिस्ट्री, गुवाहाटी यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी। द कोर्स विच इज असाइन टू मी इज एनालिटिकल केमिस्ट्री विद अ कोर्स कोड KEM351। एंड टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू प्रेजेंट माई फर्स्ट लेक्चर विच इज बेस्ड ऑन टेस्ट ऑफ सिग्निफिकेंस। This slide shows the outline of today's lecture, which will include introduction to the test of significance, important terminologies which is used in statistics, F-test and its significance in analytical chemistry, and T-test and its significance in analytical chemistry will be discussed. The first one is introduction. Now, first, the question arises that what is analytical chemistry? Analytical chemistry basically deals with quantitative and qualitative analysis. And the role of analytical chemist is to develop method for quantitative and qualitative analysis of any sample which is to be analyzed. Now, it is often desirable to compare the result of that method with those on an accepted method. For example, when analytical chemistry develop a method by performing experiment, they are oftenly then compared with other accepted method which are present in the literature. Now, if your method is significant or non-significant, then statistic will basically tells us about the significance of the method. So today's lecture is about test of significance, which are some of the parameters of statistic which will clarify that whether your method, the developed method, is significant or non-significant. This slide shows the important terminologies. These are terminologies of statistic which are very important and extensively used in analytical chemistry. So before directly going to the test of significance, these terminologies are very important to learn. So the first one is population. Population is an infinite collection of element, for example individual, item and observation. So in case of analytical chemistry, we will deal with experimental observation that we are collected in the laboratory. Or, for example, collection of soil sample. So when the number of sample which is collected from the soil is too large, then it is called population. So what is sample? Sample is a part or subset of population. It is basically that part of population which is the structural representation of the population. It consists of all the ingredients which a population contains. The third one is parameters. So constant that describe population is called parameter, and statistic a quantity that describe sample, for example function and observation. So in analytical chemistry, oftenly we will deal with sample and statistic. and thanks for your patience.